Well, hi there, Internet. My name's Court, and you've got courtside seats for my review of The Oak Room. Let's do it. The Oak Room is a thriller from director Cody Callahan and Black Fawn Films. The movie stars RJ Mitty, Peter Outerbridge, Ari Millen, Nicholas Campbell, Martin Roach, David Ferry, and Amos Crawley. During a raging snowstorm, a drifter returns home to the blue-collar bar located in the remote Canadian town where he was born. When he offers to settle an old debt with a grizzled bartender by telling him a story, the night's events quickly spin into the dark tale of mistaken identities, double crosses, and shocking violence. So welcome back to my ongoing Fantasia Fest coverage. Just a quick caveat for this video, there is construction going on outside. I'm hoping the microphone won't pick up too much of it, but just bear with me. Moving on. So this film is based on the play of the same name by Peter Genoway that premiered, I believe, at the Toronto Fringe Festival in 2013. And the movie feels very much like a play. It's a collection of scenes of dudes telling other dudes stories in a Canadian dive bar. Correction, two Canadian dive bars. I thought the acting was strong throughout with RJ Mitty, and I love Breaking Bad, he was Walter Jr. on that show. RJ Mitty really kind of kicks off the story. And he's not just talking about breakfast now. He's got some really great moments, including a self-reflection scene in a washroom that I could see coming off as over the top and comical to some. I thought it really worked. I really liked Nicholas Campbell's scene as Gord. It's a powerful scene. And this being a Canadian movie, I like to imagine that the character was named after Gord Downey. Canadians know what I'm talking about. I really liked Martin Roach as his brief role as a man passing through town with borderline hypothermia. Peter Outerbridge was the standout for me. I thought he was fantastic. And this film is really quite tense, even though it's almost entirely dialogue-driven. We, the audience, never are really sure where we stand with any given character. While it's a very different movie from Glengarry Glen Ross, it's very similar in that one finds oneself suspicious of every single character without knowing their entire story. And while I think most of the dialogue was pretty solid, there were a few lines in here and there that felt a little obvious, a little familiar, a little bit cheesy. There were moments where I thought, well, this guy just said this, so this guy's totally gonna say this. And not only did they say that, it was like word for word what I thought. Overall though, I found The Oak Room to be a pretty tense, wonderfully acted little bottle movie. The ending does not wrap it up completely in a bow, it's left a little bit ambiguous, which I kinda liked about it. But if you're okay with that, I definitely think it's worth your time. Now, I don't have a proprietary rating system as of yet, so I'm just trying to figure out what I'm gonna give The Oak Room. And I think I'm gonna give The Oak Room a...
This is, Raisin Bran. Not Raisin Bran Crunch.
Out of 10. So now I wanna know, are you looking forward to The Oak Room? What is your favorite bottle movie? You know, a movie that takes place in one location with just a couple of people of all time. Whatever your thoughts, hit the comments below. Let's discuss. If you enjoyed this review, please smash that like button and give it a share if you really enjoyed it. And hey, why not take a second, do me a favor, click subscribe and ring that bell to subscribe to my channel for more movie reviews, entertainment news, trailer reactions, all that good stuff. Check back soon for more Fantasia Fest coverage. Hope you guys are all safe and healthy. Thanks very much for watching. I will see you all in the next one. Take care.